Hello, hello. Hey, how you doing? Ryan J here. I got some notes for you. Let's do a little ethics and attitude note-taking training or a reminder of ethics and attitude. I came across this one. First and foremost, happy holidays, Merry Christmas to you. Ethics and attitude would be, when I came across this, I thought that'd be a perfect topic to talk about and shoot a video on, being it's the holiday season and it gets a little busy, could be a little stressful, and more, you might be traveling. You might have people traveling to you, whether they're staying at your house or whatever, or you're put because you're traveling, maybe you're staying in a hotel or bunking up somewhere. So that kind of it's out of the norm because you don't usually do this every single week, or maybe you do. Anyhow, that type of activity could lead to stressful situations, and you might find yourself not in the holiday spirit. So, ethics and attitude. And I found this as I was cleaning my workspace and my desk today, and it was buried under a pile of papers. I think I took this notes probably like 3 years ago, and I didn't write down the source of where I got it from. I should start doing that, writing down my sources and writing down the date I took this, because it could quite possibly have been sitting on my desk for the last 3 years. My organization might need some attention to detail. It's almost hilarious because I organize stuff in piles. I got a pile over here, I got a pile over here, and here's my training in pile over here, and here's some notes. Anyhow, I digress. All right, so I really want to say this came from a book I read by Coach John Wooden. He was the UCLA coach for many, many years, won I don't know how many championships, but I really want to say this came from his book. Excellent book, by the way. So, first and foremost, so there, let's break it down so you know what I'm talking about. It's four things to keep in mind when it comes to ethics and attitude. And it's like simple practices that you know in the back of your mind to be true, to like be a good human being. But sometimes we tend to forget the obvious things that we know to be true. So here's a little reminder. Number one, the golden rule. How'd you forget about the golden rule? Treat people how you want to be treated. That's the golden rule. And when I was recapping these notes, I like Googled the golden rule, just to like get some more information on it. And come to find out that the golden rule, or treating others how you would like to be treated, is generally world renowned in all sorts of cultures, religions. It's like a global rule recognized by pretty much everybody. So that's number one. Treat people nice how you want to be treated. Number two, ooh, and this gets tricky. Number two is two sets of threes. Well, what is that? Okay, well, here's the first set of threes. But it's two different categories with three different bullet points in it. Two sets of threes. Number one in the first set of twos. never lie. Number two, never cheat. Number three, never steal. Okay, so don't lie, don't cheat, don't steal. All right. I would tend to agree with that highly. The second set of threes, and I say this to my daughter all the time, and she like can repeat it verbatim. And she says to me, God, I know this, Dad. Don't tell me that, okay? Well, Nats, don't whine, don't complain, and don't make excuses. So no whining, no complaining, quit making excuses. Because nobody likes to listen to whining. Nobody likes a complainer. And man, the excuses, just, you know, take the personal responsibility on yourself. Like if you messed it up, be like, you know what? I kind of messed that up. And I don't have an excuse, but I will try better. And I learned this time what not to do, or how you like to be treated, or how you want it done. So don't make excuses. Just fess up to it. Number three, and this is important, and you know this in the back of your head, but with the advent of social media, it's really, really hard to keep this in mind. And that's, don't worry about being better than anybody else. But never cease trying to be the best you can be. You have control over that and nothing else. So don't compare yourself to other people. Compare yourself to who you were like yesterday, 6 months ago, a year ago, 3 years ago, and just try and, well, highly recommend that you be better than you were last week or the day before. Because that's really all you can do. And you have no control over anybody else or their actions, but you can be a better you. So that was number three. And number four is a 7-point creed. Okay. Number one, be true to yourself. Two, help others. One, it makes, when I help others, I feel good about it. So whether that's, for example, just last week or a couple, 2-3 days ago, you know, I helped my neighbor blow out his driveway because his snowblower broke, and it would have taken him hours to like blow out his driveway or shovel his driveway because there's about 6, 7, 8 inches of snow. So helping others, and that's like helping my neighbor. He appreciated it. I felt good, and I had the snowblower up and running anyway. So what's the, you know, big issue of going next door and helping him? Help others. Make each day your masterpiece. That's number three. Make each day your masterpiece. So that's, you know, trying the best you can every single day. Easier said than done. Yes, I agree. Easier said than done. But get yourself a to-do list and get yourself a must-do list. Now, the to-do list can wait, but the must-do list must get done. So that's a simple action you can take to make every day your masterpiece. So whether that's, well, I don't know, it might be different for everybody's must-do list is different than what mine is. So a little bit of self-reflection on that and you can figure that out. Number four, and I like this one. Drink deeply from the good books, including the good book. Including the good book, which would be the Bible. So whether that's whether that's books to on personal development, whether it's good books on, well, whatever your interest is and knowledge, and you'd like to expand upon that, read those books. You know, read autobiographies. You know, read the self-development books. You know, knowledge is power. So read. Five, make friendship a fine art. That kind of goes, well, they all kind of tie hand in hand. But relationships and friendships and cultivating those relationships, that's important. A little bit of bonus. If you say you're going to do something, you know, stick to your word. Be true to yourself and your word. Stick to it. And then people know, like, and trust you. And when you say something, they know that you're going to do it. Make friendship a fine art. Number six, build a shelter against a rainy day. Okay. That can be taken like in the literal sense, like building a shelter for when it does rain. But I like to take it in the sense of when you're saving or investing money, you know, to put a portion aside, 10% is strongly recommended to save or invest, whether that be in yourself or, you know, some sort of investment vehicle, to make that grow and make that start working for you on the investment side. So when, you know, the vid happens and you can't go to work for like a month and a half or a year and a half or 2 years or whatever it is, you at least have a little bit of reserve for that rainy day fund. All right. So build a shelter against a rainy day. Number seven, praying for guidance and giving thanks. Praying for guidance and giving thanks. So that might be literally praying. That might be in your meditation. That might be taking yourself 10 minutes in the morning to like be clear on your intentions, to be clear on your goals, to set your mindset right for the day, before all the commotion and being not reactive, but being prepared for the uncertainty, which is certain is gonna happen. So praying for guidance, giving thanks, Maybe it's taking 5 seconds every hour, setting a timer on your phone or watch or whatever, to just give thanks and be grateful and have gratitude for just that 1 hour. And then the next hour, you can do it again. So that was number seven. And at the bottom here, I have a word written, intentiveness. Maybe I should Google this, intentiveness. I don't know if I made that up or if this is actually a true word. But I also wrote, it suggests persistence, determination, fortitude, and resolve. Persistence, determination, fortitude, and resolve. So with intentiveness, tying that into the ethics and attitude and the four examples that we gave, or I gave, on the golden rule, the two sets of threes, being better than you were the day before and not comparing yourself to others, and the seven-point creed with persistence, determination, fortitude, and resolve. I can't see how that's a failing situation. Matter of fact, it's gonna be extremely beneficial for you and change your life. If you like this, what I can do, and if you would like this, you can, one, rewatch the video and take your own notes. 2, get into the comments or send me a message somehow, and I can scan it on over to you. I can get that going for you. Yeah, so that's ethics and attitude. I hope this was a reminder for you. I hope that it provided value. And of course, I wish you a safe, happy holidays and Merry Christmas to you. Till next time, make it an epic day. Bye.